Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Stephen Colbert.
To be here to host this panel on the Prime Video series, The Lord of the Rings, The Rings of Power. But before we get started, how about a round of applause for series composer Bear McCreary and his orchestra? Thank you, Bear. Absolutely beautiful. Thank you so much. Well, I am here today as a fan of J.R.R. Tolkien and of all things Arda. And I don't think most of you would be here today if you didn't share that passion and a deep curiosity of how the artists we will meet today will, over the next 5 seasons, take us all into the cataclysmic events of the Second Age. My introduction to Tolkien was when I read The Lord of the Rings when I was around 12 years old. My friend Keith Sargi gave it to me. I was instantly absorbed by this world. I remember lying on the couch one day, and I was reading The Two Towers. I was in the chapter of the Uruk-hai. And at one point, I suddenly sat bolt upright, gasping for breath, because I realized that I had been holding my breath for the last 2 pages. Because reading Tolkien is swimming in deep water. I've now read the trilogy innumerable times. I lost count around 50. And 46 years later, I am still discovering new things about it and from it. And here, I just want to take a moment to give a very grateful hat tip to the Tolkien professor, Corey Olson. I'm now on episode 178 of his Exploring the Lord of the Rings podcast, which is a page-by-page and sometimes word-by-word exploration of the story. I'm about 300 hours into his lecture series, and we haven't quite made it because the depth of the text and the implied depth of Tolkien's text is one of the things that's so extraordinary about the professor. You feel like any question that you have, old Tollers had that question first, and he wrote about it somewhere. But one of the places where the information is the thinnest is the Second Age. And that is when the Rings of Power is set, thousands of years before Frodo and Sam, when the world had not yet lost the light and the music of the Elder Days. That's a story of hope and encroaching darkness, unlikely friendships, of home, and this being Tolkien, it's a story of loss. I've seen a little bit of it, but I have declined their kind offer to watch the entire season because I want to discover, along with you and everybody else, what parts of that known story are going to be told and how that implied world is explored. Who here has a copy of The Lord of the Rings on their bookshelf? Okay. Who here has read the appendices? Okay, who here is lying about having read the appendices? Now, you probably know this, but for those who don't, the appendices are where most of the unique source material for the Rings of Power series comes from, and they were very important to Tolkien. He wanted to create a Gesamtkunstwerk, a complete work of art. Yeah, Gesamtkunstwerk, baby. A complete work of art painted on the grand backdrop of a mythic, undiscovered culture. And one of the things that got me so engrossed as I read The Lord of the Rings are the passing references, the little unexplained windows into the past. Who is Elendil the Tall, and just how tall was he? Who is Fëanor, and why did Gandalf want to perceive his unimaginable hand and mind at work? What does Gildor and Glorian mean by the House of Finrod? What the hell is a flammifer of Westerness? So I'm looking forward to all the possibilities. I want to see Moria before the fall. Will we, in the next 5 seasons, get to see the doors of Durin being made by Narvi and Celebrimbor? And how did Sauron fool them with his Anatar disguise? Of course, it can be challenging to have something you love as much as The Lord of the Rings and that entire world taken on by someone new. And I've gotten to meet showrunners J.D. Payne and Patrick McKay. We had lunch, because I'm fancy. And I am struck by their sincerity and their love of this world. So I'm going to bring them out here in just a moment and ask them simply, what is the story you are telling? Who are these characters? And how does all of this fit into the lore of Tolkien? But don't worry, I'll also ask the hard-hitting, important questions like, why do some elves have haircuts? And where is the salon? And do female dwarves have beards? Today, we'll get some answers and meet the showrunners and the cast, and we'll see some surprises along the way. Y'all ready for this? Me too. Good. Let's get this long-expected party started.